Please welcome the Honorable Royal Historian of Arendelle, Aria!
Near and far, I am Aria, royal historian to the court of Arendelle, and it is my honor to share with you the history of Arendelle. Oh, Princess Anna! Oh my goodness! I had no idea you would be here.
Hi, everybody! Wow, there are so many people here.
Oh, yes, but you're not supposed to be on stage yet.
I know. I just wanted to come out a little early to make sure you were ready for our secret plan. You know, Eric's big moment.
Yes, now Eric is a lovely apprentice, but are you sure he's really ready to be a royal historian?
Totally ready. But he is just such a sweet guy, and I want him to do brilliantly today.
Oh, well, in that case, Princess Anna, rest assured I will do everything I can to make sure he comes through with flying colors.
Perfect. Oh, but remember, it's a secret.
Oh, yes, of course.
Oh, you don't have to curtsy to me. I'm not the queen. But I have a feeling we'll be seeing her later. Bye for now.
Bye. Ladies and gentlemen, Princess Anna. I nearly forgot why I came here. Yes, it is my honor to share with you the history of Arendelle. But I will need a little help. Eric, it's time.
Sorry, I'm late. There were frozen fractals all around. Mm-hmm. Hey, do you want to build a snowman?
Eric, we're here to tell a story.
Okay, bye.
No, come back here. What are you doing? I need your help. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Eric.
Hi, Eric.
Royal historian.
No, sir, not yet. Right now, you are my apprentice. Did you forget? But the time will come when you'll be able to prove yourself a true historian, and then you will earn your crest of honor, like mine. As we recount our memorable tale, we invite you all to join us in the singing of many of our Arendelle anthems.
Ooh, that means songs.
Yes, so let us begin at the beginning.
Once upon a time, there was a cute little clownfish.
No, not that one.
A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
No, sorry, not that one either. Allow me. It was a beautiful day in the kingdom of Arendelle.
Oh, yes, and there were two sisters who loved each other very much.
Yes, Princess Elsa and Princess Anna.
Princess Elsa was different. She was born with special powers, magical powers that create snow and ice.
Yes, the two girls just loved playing in the magical snow that Elsa created. But one day, something terrible happened. Elsa accidentally struck Anna in the head with her freezing powers. The king and queen rushed Anna to seek help from the trolls.
Grandpappy, king of the trolls, fixed Anna's head and removed all memories of magic.
Listen to me, Elsa. Your power will only grow. There is beauty in it. But also great danger. You must learn to control it. Fear will be your enemy.
They decided to keep Elsa's powers hidden from Anna.
Poor thing. Anna felt so alone and she couldn't understand why.
It didn't make any sense to her that Elsa refused to answer the question that Anna kept asking and asking.
Elsa?
Sing along.
Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door, it's like you've gone away. Do you want to build a snowman? It doesn't have to be a snowman.
Go away, Anna.
Okay, bye.
Do you want to build a snowman? On the walls.
Hang in there, Joan.
It gets a little lonely. All these empty rooms, just watching the hours tick by.
See you in 2 weeks.
have to go.
You'll be fine, Elsa.
But what, did they get lost at sea?
Yes. And it is very sad. However, it leads Elsa forward to the most important day in her young life. Coronation Day!
Oh, good times, good times.
Yes. Well, several years had passed, and it was now time for Princess Elsa to take the crown.
She stole the crown?
No. She did not steal the crown. It was just time for her to be crowned queen, that's all.
Ooh, what about her ice and snow powers?
Good question. She was afraid that those powers would show, and she would be cast out of the kingdom forever.
All the while, Anna found herself dreaming of the adventures that waited outside when the castle doors were opened for the first time in forever!
It's Coronation Day! It's Coronation Day!
The window is open, so's that door.
I didn't know they did that anymore. Who knew we owned 8,000 salad plates? For years I've roamed these empty halls. Why have a ballroom with no balls? Finally they're opening up the gates. They'll be actual real-life people. It'll be totally strange.
The one.
Tonight, imagine me gown and all, fetchingly draped against the wall, the picture of sophisticated grace. I suddenly see him standing magic. It'll be fun for the first time in forever. I could be noticed by someone. And I know it is totally crazy to dream I
Princess Anna does meet someone tall, dark, and dreamy. Yeah. Prince Hans of the Southern Isles.
I don't like the looks of this guy. He's too good looking to be good.
Oh, hush. You're just jealous. He's dreamy.
Conceal, don't feel. Look, Ma, no Hans. Oh, well, don't forget, it's Coronation Day.
Oh, yes. Now, Elsa was nervous, but she was able to hide her powers long enough to be crowned queen.
And then they partied and ate chocolate, and it was amazing.
Well, it was a little awkward for Elsa and Anna at first. After all, they hadn't seen each other in years, but it seemed as if maybe, just maybe, that would change.
And then Hans came back, and he and Anna danced the night away.
Oh, don't you just love true love?
Yeah, I don't think this was true love. They'd only just met.
Oh, well, Anna certainly thought so.
I would never shut you up.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
Sing along, everyone!
How crazy?
All my life has been a series of doors in my face, and then suddenly I bump into you.
I was thinking the same thing, because, like, I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate. I mean, it's crazy. We finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me. Jinx! Jinx again!
Our mental synchronization
can't have but one explanation.
You
and I
were
just meant to be. Say goodbye.
Say goodbye to the pain of the past. We don't have to feel it anymore. Love is an open door. Life can be so much more.
With you.
Love is an open door. Can I say something crazy?
Not so fast. Queen Elsa said, "Oh, you can't marry a man you just met."
Well, That is true. And unfortunately, Anna pushed Elsa a little too far, causing Elsa to accidentally conjure up ice all over the ballroom.
People called her a witch and a sorcerer. She even impaled someone.
What? No, she didn't. No, she didn't. Stop spreading that rumor. But everyone was scared, but perhaps not as scared as Queen Elsa herself. She ran away across the fjord of Arendelle, freezing everything as she went. In fact, she froze all of Arendelle, sending it into a dark, cold curse.
It was beyond cold. It was froze.
Poor Elsa couldn't come back now because everyone knew she had magical powers.
But being alone gave her a chance to find out who she was, what she wanted, and to sing a really cool song.
Oh, Eric. Did you just make that up? Yeah.
Think she'd like more flowers or, now hear me out, chocolates.
Why don't you get her both? Hey everybody, cheer if you think you should get her both.
It's a good idea. Maybe Oaken's having one of his big summer blowouts. Well, thanks guys, I'll see you later.
You're welcome.
Happy anniversary. Anniversary. Where were we?
Kristoff and Anna were making their way up the North Mountain where they met...
Olaf!
Yes, Olaf!
Oh, he likes warm hugs and summer!
Yes.
Summer? Oh, I don't know why, but I've always loved the idea of summer and sun and all things hot.
Really? I'm guessing you don't have much experience with heat.
Nope.
But sometimes I like to close my eyes and imagine what it'd be like when summer does come. Bees will buzz, kids will blow dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. In my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. Blah, 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 blah. The cold are both so intense, putting together it just makes sense.
Eric, oh, Eric, I must have sung too hard on that last song. Now I'm losing my voice. Yeah, oh, I can't believe I'm about to ask you this, but will you lead all of us in the next part of the story?
Me?
Eric, this is your chance to prove you're more than just an apprentice. Eric, seize the day and share the story with us. Okay. You can do it.
Okay.
There you see. They believe in you.
Olaf, Anna, and Kristoff made their way up the North Mountain. Elsa and Anna got into an argument, and it was just like their childhood all over again. Except this time, Elsa zapped Anna in the heart.
My mistake.
And she sent a giant ice monster after them.
On purpose.
Anna and Kristoff almost died by jumping off a cliff, but luckily the snow softened their fall. Oh, and we learned the most important thing of all. Olaf has no skull and no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
Anna's hair started to turn white, so Kristoff took to see the love experts, and they tried to get Kristoff to marry Anna.
Even though she was still engaged to Prince Hans of the Southern Isles.
But it was too late. Anna was getting colder by the minute, and as Poppy said,
only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
So they raced off to Arendelle to find Hans so he could melt Anna's heart with a true love's kiss. And when they were alone together by the fireplace, Hans leaned in to kiss Anna when all of a sudden he laughed in her face. Ha ha ha! He left Anna in a cold room to freeze and he sentenced Elsa to death. Also, he could take over the kingdom.
Yes. Okay, but then Olaf came to Anna's rescue.
He helped Anna realize that Kristoff, not Hans, was her true love. Meanwhile, Hans is pursuing Elsa on the ice, whose powers are going crazy, summoning up a giant winter storm.
Yes, out of that frozen fjord, Anna ran, shuffled to Kristoff as she started to freeze. But then she saw Hans about to kill her sister. Should she save herself or her sister? What to do?
And Elsa said,
take care of my sister. And Hans shot back,
your sister is dead because of you. And he's just about to kill Elsa with his sword when Anna suddenly jumped in the way, saving her sister, but freezing to death like an ice cube. And then everything got all magical and sparkly because Anna was alive after all. It was actually her act of true love that could thaw frozen hearts. And she saved herself and her sister and the entire kingdom. The end. Voice back.
Yes, I lied about that. I had Your Highness.
You're Kristoff Ness. I don't know.
I told you he was ready.
You were right, Princess Anna.
Huh?
Eric, I knew you could do it. And so, by order of the Queen, you are hereby being promoted from apprentice historian to official royal historian of Arendelle.
This is the best day ever! Wait, by royal order of the Queen? You mean she's here?
She sure is! Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, allow me to present my sister, Queen Elsa!
Singing the anthems of Arendelle.
Yeah, it was almost like they had heard these songs before.
Yes, you all did a wonderful job. Such a great great job, in fact, that I hereby decree that you are